most people, this is kind of against rules of saltwater fishing, but speckled trout fishing, 13 Fishing has a new crankbait out, which is called the Jabberjaw. The blade moves, wobbles a lot, makes a lot of noise, great color patterns on them. And I will tell you, this bait will catch you more speckled trout and probably larger ones also. We're gonna try it today and see what happens. There he is. Oh, that's a nice one. Very nice one. Now I'm going to tell y'all, the Jabberjaw is a crankbait. Most people don't use crankbait for speckled trout. They just don't do it, including most anglers here in Southeast Louisiana. Here's a nice one right here off the bat. Look at that. Caught him. And why the reason that is that most people just don't do it because they think it's a bass bait. But really, it's not a freshwater bass bait. It's used for a lot of different saltwater species. Just people don't ever use them because they don't have confidence in it. But hopefully, I'll change your mind today. Nice, good 13-inch speckled trout. Now, the proper way to do this is I have a leader tied on. I've got 30-pound test leader on here. I've got this Jabberjaw right here. And I have my current going away from me. If I would throw up current, I would have to reel it a lot quicker. But what I'm doing is that with speckled trout, I really find you throw it out, and then that bait dives and wiggles like this, makes a lot of movement, sound, displacement. But because my current's going that way, I can reel really, really slow. The bait digs down. It stays kind of in one position for a very long time, and speckled trout just can't refuse it. This has been kind of one of my secrets for a long time with crankbaits, with fishing redfish also. And a lot of anglers will say that they fish them, but they really don't. I can promise you, I know. Another nice speckled trout right here. That's two and two cast. I think they're on it. Nice one. He's trying to be free. Spit up all over my boat. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm fishing a shallow flat. And what that does is that I have this bait hitting, oh, there's one. I have it hitting the oyster shells as I'm reeling it really slow. The bait's not really suspending. What it's doing is it's digging in the bottom. It's causing a reaction strike from these fish, which most crankbaits do. And the reason for that is as it's hitting and wobbling and hitting on the ground, those speckled trout hear that, they sense it, they feel it, and then the profile makes them bite it. It's just an instinctive strike. And I don't know if you noticed it yet or not, but you never really set the hook on these fish. You kind of just reel. The reason why is that this treble hook's all over the place on this thing. It will hook these fish. I mean, this one's outside of them because that's the extra one that's kind of like your guarantee. And then this one's in the mouth where he was striking it. Just another beautiful speckled trout. And these are all keepers here in Louisiana, 12 inches. This one's probably about 13 and a half right here. Beautiful fish. Okay, now I've caught a lot of fish on this so far. I'm getting dirty from these speckled trout. They're really slimy. Some things that you might want to do when you're fishing these baits is that you do have to change up your speed of your retrieve. You have to find out that special, speed that those fish want, because that's the key, is that however they want it, how it's wobbling. Sometimes it's reeling it fast and jerking it, and reeling it fast and jerking it where it's hitting. Along jetties, it's a really good bait also, because they don't get stuck on the jetties really bad. So they'll hit the rocks and they make a lot of noise, and it just, the instinctive strike of these fish on these type of baits is awesome. But I find today, because my current's going out, that I'm kind of fighting the current a little bit. So the current's actually doing like a retrieve for me. The current movement has this bait moving on its own. And what it's doing is that is making that bait wobble and move out there in the water. That one I probably never got a bite, because I'm getting a bite almost every cast. But that one I probably didn't get a bite due to the reason I had a little bit of grass on it. And that's from being on the bottom, hitting those oyster shells. There's a little grass down there, and that's what happens. Now, as you're far out and you throw really far, you can keep your rod tip high. But as you come in, you want to drop your rod tip slowly like this. And the reason why is that'll keep it at the same depth, and it'll allow you to go deeper as it goes. When you have it way out and the rod's up, it actually makes the bait dive even better. So that's just kind of like a little trick. Ooh, I just got a little bite. That's a little trick that you can do, is that when you cast out, keep it up, and as you come in, you drop it down, okay? Let's see. There he is. Just like that. And as I was getting closer, I started dropping that rod because I stopped feeling the bottom. I wasn't hitting it. So as you start not feeling the bottom, you want to go ahead and you want to drop that rod tip. Seems like a pretty nice fish. Yeah, it's good ones. They're all constantly the same, just like speckled trout do, about 14 incher here. They're all about the same. They hold the net in schools. These fish are feeding on croakers right now and some shrimp, but mostly croaker fin fish. So that's why this bait works so well, is because this definitely mimics a bait fish, without a doubt, going through the water. Nice fish. Oh, there's a good one. Oh, there's a nice one on it. Well, I'll tell y'all, this is an awesome, unconventional way to catch speckled trout. The Jabba Jaw, I'll have a link down there to get on it. Man, it seems like a really nice fish, y'all. Best one today, for sure. Let's see. Stay out of it. Oh, yeah, nice one. Look at that. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Beautiful. And that's the way that these fish eat this, as you can see. Don't spit it out. Gorgeous fish on the 13 Fishing Jabba Jaw. Awesome bait, makes a lot of action, and keeps fishermen happy all the time. I'm telling y'all, you try this bait, you will without a doubt on the comments below will comment and say how awesome a trip you had using these, and you would have never thought about it. I promise you. Make sure, subscribe below, and give us some comments about the fish you catch.